Hey guys, Ron here. I don't know who that dork Cameron is that seems to be all over the internet, but today I'm gonna show you how to dye some plastic. Now, typically I would just spray paint this stuff, but we're working on a pretty dandy CR250 here, so this time around I'm gonna do it right. Now, in order to get this project started, we're gonna need a pan or pot that the parts will fit in, some acetone, and this is the dye. It is called Rit Dye More. Gonna be doing black on these parts. And the parts I'll be doing are the radiator guards, front sprocket cover, your brake line guide, and just for the heck of it, I'm gonna try to do the shock bumper. This is like made of dense rubber. Not sure if it'll accept the dye, but if it does, that'll be cool because I absolutely hate that yellow color. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention, we're gonna need a stovetop oven as well. Ideally, you should have this in a shop environment so it's ventilated properly since we'll be using acetone, but I guess you could get away with doing it in the house as well. Just don't tell your significant other. Now, we're gonna need to clean this stuff up with Dawn dish soap or degreaser before we get to dyeing. So now we're gonna mix the dye, the acetone, and water here in this pan, and we're gonna do this at room temperature so it doesn't react. If you have hot water and you add in acetone, it'll react and could possibly burn you. So we're gonna mix it at a 12% ratio for the dye. So if you're using one cup of water, use about an eighth cup of dye. And then the acetone is gonna be at a 5% ratio. So some of you guys might be wondering, why are we using acetone for dyeing? Well, it opens up the pores in the plastic and helps the plastic absorb the dye better. So you kind of have to play with the ratio of the acetone. If your plastic is not accepting the dye very well, you're gonna have to use more acetone. And if the acetone or if the plastic is being melted or deformed in the dye, then you're gonna have to use less acetone. So we've got 12 cups of water in the pan. So that means we're gonna use 1.5 cups of dye. Now with the dye added in there, we're at 13.5 cups of fluid. So 5% of that would be 5.5 ounces of acetone. Think about a little too much acetone. Got a whole freaking gallon here. You know what? Probably a good idea to wear some gloves for this project. If you get this stuff on your hands, it's gonna stain it pretty good. Now with the pan on the stove, we're gonna get this solution up to 200 degrees and then we'll be ready to start dipping some parts in. So like I said earlier, you're gonna want to exhaust out these fumes since we're using acetone. So get a fan going, open up the doors, and I would recommend wearing a respirator as well. Looks like this stuff's getting ready to boil, so I'm gonna check the temperature on it. 182, so close enough to 200. Let's go ahead and drop a part in there and see what it does. So let's go ahead and see what these parts look like after 15 minutes of soaking. Looks pretty black to me. Actually, there's a little bit of white still showing through right up on top there. So I am gonna have to add a little bit more acetone to this mixture. Sprocket guard looks pretty similar as well. The black is pretty spotty and some of that gray still showing through. Let's take a look at the shock bumper. Ooh, that one looks pretty black. Sweet, I think we might have some luck with that one. So I'm gonna add about 2 ounces of acetone at a time, but like I explained earlier, you do not wanna add it to a warm solution. So I'm gonna have to let that cool off for a bit before I add that extra acetone. I apologize for the noise in the background, got the exhaust fan going. So if it's kind of fuzzy, that's why. So while that solution's cooling down, I thought I'd take a little closer look at these parts. Sprocket cover accepted the dye pretty evenly. Just not quite as black as I would have hoped. The guide is a little bit spotty, pretty much a gray color now. And one thing that just occurred to me, I think the sprocket cover will look a lot better without this little extra portion here. So I'm gonna trim that off right at this line here. That looks so much better. Just use a little hacksaw and then 120 grit sandpaper and finish it off with 320 grit. Pretty pumped. All right, so I pulled the shock bumper out of the solution. I would say that thing absorbed it pretty much perfect. So this bumper is just an extra one I had laying around to test. So I'm gonna take a little scalpel here and see if I can scrape off any of that dye. Pretty impressive stuff. That dye won't even scrape off. And then when I pinch it or like flex it,
won't flake off either. So yeah, pretty surprised how well it holds up. Now I just need to get these pieces dialed in. All right, guys, we got some results. Pretty pumped with how this stuff came out. Some of the pieces are a little bit flatter in color, or actually a little bit purplish, like this mud flap. Just stole that off of Haley's XR80 over here. Also did the chain guide as well. But these pieces, for the most part, look pretty good. I would say the shock bumpers turned out the best of all, just a really solid black. But for these pieces that turned out a little bit flatter, that don't have much shine to them, got an idea for you guys. And so what we're gonna be using is called Seracote Trim Coat. Gotta make sure this stuff is completely cooled down and dry. Then we're gonna wipe it down with this ceramic coating. Here's the results of the trim coat. Pretty pumped on how this stuff came out. Definitely brightened up and shined that color up pretty good. So that trim coat's gonna add a layer of protection as well. So yeah, can't go wrong. We've got the radiator guard all finished up, and man, this thing turned out sweet. Couple things I learned throughout this process is the bigger parts, or some plastic in particular, you're gonna have to use a little bit more acetone and a little bit more dye, as well as more time. So this guard took about an hour to completely dye. And you can see it turned out pretty dang black. I haven't done any trim coat on it yet. Might put some of that on top just to shine it up a little bit. But overall, really stoked with how this one came out. So I would recommend buying about 3 of these bottles if you're gonna be doing radiator guards. If you're gonna be doing something smaller like a shock bumper, you'll just need 1. And then as far as acetone mixture, this one took about a 10% acetone mixture. So definitely do not be afraid to add some more acetone and more dye if you're not getting the results that you want. And also one more thing, if you're gonna be doing trim coat on top of this stuff, you gotta leave the part out in the sun to completely dry out. It's gonna have a little bit of water left over from the dyeing process. So you gotta have that thing completely dried out before you put that trim coat on. All right, time to see if this dye is actually gonna hold up to the conditions it'll see on the bike. So over here, it's kind of inconspicuous when it's on the bike. So I'm gonna try scraping this stuff off, see if that'll do anything. Looks like that held up remarkably well. It's more just scratching the plastic and not really removing any of the color. So next, I'm gonna try gas and acetone. First up is acetone. Doesn't touch it at all. And now we've got some gas. I doubt this will touch it either. Yeah, same result. Still holding up really good. And the last thing I'm gonna do is bend the plastic. Just make sure it hasn't lost any flexibility, and to see if that dye will flake off. Still looks like just how it was before. So yeah, pretty dang impressed with this dye. It looks like it's gonna hold up extremely well on the bike. One last idea for you guys that are struggling to get a good dye on your parts is to leave the part overnight in the dye. So this one I left overnight just in the cold dye. You can see it's a bit darker than the other side, which was only dyed for about an hour. So yeah, it made a pretty good difference there. I'm actually tempted to dye this one a little bit more. The other side turned out really, really good. So I'm gonna get this stuff on the bike and check it out. All right, so now where to source the supplies for this project. I found the dye at a local Hobby Lobby. Make sure you get the dye more version. You don't want the standard version like this. It won't work. You could probably find this stuff at Walmart too. Same with the pan. The acetone I got at Home Depot. You really only need a quart size. You don't need a whole freaking gallon like I bought here. I will also drop a link down below to where you can find the Seracote Trim Coat stuff. I am so freaking amped how this stuff turned out. You definitely do not need to go buy new plastics if you're only changing the color. And one more thing for you guys, if you did not see the last video I posted on the new 8 series Electron Carb that I have right here, definitely go head over to the channel and check that out. I'm actually giving away one of these carburetors to one of you guys. So if you want to find out how to enter that giveaway, go watch that video over on the channel.
All right, that is going to wrap up this video. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and hopefully you can go ahead and apply these same techniques to do your own plastic dyeing at home, just like we did here. I'm going to go and shave off this magnificent thing so I can get back to being Cameron, and I will see you guys in a future video. One last thing before I go, the day after I post this video, which will be July 27th, I will be at the Washougal Pro National down in Portland, Oregon. So if any of you guys are headed out there to watch the race, if you see me, come say what's up. I hope to see a lot of you guys out there. Later.